faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's heart. You lead me by still water into mercy, and nothing can keep us apart. Still water into mercy, nothing can, and nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. So remember, so
the precious
cleansing to Calvary's tide. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Sin slains are lost in His life-giving flow. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is blood of the Lamb. Who should do service for Jesus our King? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Who should live daily His praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder working power in the blood.
Say Chata hu mere kudaa.
se karunga aratuna teri me man se karunga aratuna teri shamat se karunga mera hai kuta mera Ephesians chapter 1 verse 17 to 23. We read together. Verse 17. I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparable great power for us who believe. The power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated at him at his right hand in the heavenly realms. Verse 21, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one who come. 22, and God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church. Verse 23, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. Amen. Let's pray together. Our loving Father, thank you so much. You collect us from the pit, from the sinners. You brought us into the great light. That's why we are here, to worship you as your own people. Lord, Holy Spirit, move among us and touch our heart so we can come to you close and want to listen to the word of God from your mouth, the wisdom, the bread of our life. Lord, you say that when we listen to the word of God, Holy Spirit, help us to have more faith, strong faith. Lord, even big situation we have, trouble comes, and we can be more strong. Thank you so much. This time you help us, even me, speaker, some people, listener, all of us in your hand. Thank you. We give you glory, honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much you gather this place and in an internet place. And hopefully God open our church. So with all this situation gone and after that, we can get together in one place in our church. Okay? We pray for each other. We stick together each other. That is what we have to do. Amen. Now we just want to share the word of God today. I just want to make this theme of my sermon. Great power. So many movies in this time is a superhero movie. That they have a power. Some the different kind of power they have. Anyway, if you have superpower, what you are going to do? If you have a superpower, maybe I can fly. So, with my whole family together and visit my house in Korea and come back very soon. Yeah. What about you? You have a superpower, and what you are going to do? This Ephesians chapter 1 was finishing with this prayer. Paul's prayer for Ephesian people. They are Gentile, like you and me, not Israel people. We already read this Bible
I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation, so that you may know Him better, know our God better. That's the first prayer. Second prayer is here. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened, open, in order that you may know three things. The hope to which He has called you. In the first sermon, I told you that. Second, the riches of His glorious inheritance in His holy people. Well, last sermon, I told you that. Today, 19 to 23, He was telling about the power. Read it again. And His incomparable great power for us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength He exalted when He raised Christ from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in the heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked it, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. And God placed all things under His feet and appointed Him to be head over everything for the church, which is His body, the fullness of Him who fills everything in every way. He prayed three things today. He said, enlighten your heart, open your heart, so you have to know, you may know that first, second, three, last one today, the power, incomparable power. You have to know that. That's why He's praying like this. That Ephesian people has to know this incomparable power. I just want to tell you today about this power. What is power is this? Paul is not asking. Paul is not praying to give this power. Many people in the world, another religion, they always pray the same. Give me, give me, give me. Give me something, give me something. Paul, our Christianity, is very important prayer, is more than give us something. Today, Paul is just three thing prayer, to know them. Let them know about it. Let them know something. It's important. Verse 19, I want to read again. This said, I pray that you may know and His incomparable great power for us who believe. The power is the same as the mighty strength. I want to say to you, Paul is not asking the power. Paul is not praying for, give them a power. That's why I'm asking you, if you have a superpower, what are you going to do? Many times we dream like this, if I have a power and I can do something more than that. But today Bible said, you have to know the power is already on you. Amen? This power, incomparable power, is already on you. You have this power. In the Bible said that you have to know that things. Oh, I have a power? What kind of power I have? I just want to tell you that. This power is already working the people who believe Jesus Christ. Amen? John 16:33, he said, I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you have a trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Amen? Jesus said, I have overcome the world. It is not saying, I will give this overcome. Jesus said, I have overcome the world. It is already begun. It has already done. If you have a trouble in your life, because it is, it's true. Because we have a lot of problem we have. We can't avoid this kind of virus too. But God said, take heart. I have overcome the world. It's already begun. That power is already working in all people who believe Jesus Christ. I just want to tell you that this order verse 17 to 23, power, I can explain three kind of power he wants to say. First power, this power overcome for the death. Actually, death came into the world for what? Why people died? Bible said because of sin. Romans chapter 6, 23 said, for the wage of sin is death. Wage of sin is death. If you commit sin, that means you're going to die. That was the original punishment from the Genesis. They were in a garden of Eden. If you take that fruit, was forbidden about the knowledge of the good and evil. That's the order from God. Just one order. You disobeyed it. That means commit sin. You commit sin, you will be dead. That time, before that time, it has no idea about the death. Only have a life. Because God created everything perfectly. Nobody was dead. Even a small insect, some mosquito, never died. Because of our sin, that is occurred. That is started. That is start with the sin. That's why in the Bible says, wage of sin is death. Sin is coming to the world, death is started. If we have no death, what's the problem with you? Yeah, you have no food in your house, you worry a lot, but you never die. There's no problem. You have a sick, you have an ill in your body, you have a cancer or heart attack you have. What's the worry? You never die. All problem is there, coming from the death. If we have a death, that's why we afraid, calm. Fear was started because of the death. Why are you afraid someone has knife in their hands? Why? If you have no death, you never die. That means you have no afraid. All kind of problem we have also, that is all coming from the death. Because death is occurring in our heart, that's why inside, deep inside of our heart, we are afraid of the death. The fear is come from our heart. So all kind of situation, we worry. Maybe your children sick a lot and really high fever, temperature is going high, 38 to 40, something like that. If you know about that, they never die, that means you can say that, oh, it's okay, you never die. Death is the cause for everything. Verse 20, it said, the power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated at him at his right hand in the heavenly realm, in the Bible said. That is the power of the resurrection. Amen? That is very essence of Christianity. Very important things for our belief. Jesus is the God, the Son of God. Many people question about it. Why Jesus died? He is God. You're right. It's true. God never died. Why he has to come to the world? Why he abandoned of the crown and seated at the right hand of God? Why he come to the world as a baby and the Bethlehem has no place? Why? Why? We have no idea. We can't understand things, right? Everything is something mystery. We can't understand that thing. He has to be death for all the people's sin. That's the reason we know that. That's why he come. Even he is God. And he rose again from the dead. He beat the power of the death. He rose again from the dead. He demonstrates something to us. He wants to show us something. I'm the first fruit of resurrection. Who gonna be a second, third, fourth, hundredth? He wants to show us something he can do. He said, watch me, what I can do. Watch me. I'm the example, live again from the death. He wants to say. That is the meaning of the power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated at him his right hand and his heavenly realm. The Bible said, he wants to say something to us. Without my permission, you can't die. Amen? You know, the Bible said, I'm the man who controls life and death. Jesus wants to show you and me, even you die, and you will live again. John 11:25-26, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will die, will never die. Do you believe this? That's the question. He is the one have a power to overcome the death. Second, this power overcome the word. I told you already. Verse 21, he said, and seated at him at his right hand in the heavenly realm. Verse 20, he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly realm. Verse 21, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. Verse 22, and God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be hand over everything for the church. He is above all else. Nobody can beat him. He is the rule, everything. In the Bible said, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in this present age, but also in the one to come. God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church. He is above all. We sing that song, above all power, above all king, above all nation and all created thing, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all power, above all throne, above all wonder the world has ever known. Above all, everything, he is there for us. What kind of people can beat him? What kind of nation overcome to him? Even the world ruling by the Satan, they wants to kill the Christianity a long time ago. All the Christians' life was threatened and persecution they have. Our Christianity is growing up like a big tree. What kind of authority, what kind of dominion, what kind of tyranny, they beat our God. They come against our God, amen? Every kind of things, they can't beat it. Because God is rule everything above all else. God is control the world. God is bigger than our world. Every history is in his hand. Amen. Paul is praying that. Please let them know that Ephesian people, they are afraid a lot. They have a fear of the world. That's why I pray, let them know. Enlighten their heart, eyes of their heart, and their eyes open so they know better and better, know about this power already on us with Jesus Christ. Amen. Nobody can against our God. The lastly, I just want to tell you this power is fill the church. Amen. The fullness. Verse 22-23 said, and God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church. This is the first mention of the church today in the Bible said. God placed all things under his feet, Jesus' feet, appointed him to be head over everything for the church. Amen? Our church is just like that. So you church, the Ephesian church, has to know about it. You have a power like this. Verse 23 said, which is his body? This church is the body of Jesus Christ. The fullness, the church is fullness of Him who fills everything in every way. Amen? The Bible said, the church is the body of Jesus Christ, and Jesus is in His head. And in the Bible said, that church is the fullness of Jesus Christ. Amen? What is meaning of fullness in the Bible? Fullness means perfect, complete, everything. Look at our church. Is it perfect? No, actually it's not. Our church is not much perfect. But God wants to fill the church with everything in every way. Amen? That's why that church is very important for you and me. That church, the congregation of you and me, we get together, two or three together, in the name of Jesus. That is the church. Jesus is there. Amen? What is the plan of God? What is the power of God? God wants to fill and wants to make complete, wants to make perfect before the Lord, because the head is Jesus Christ. Amen? We have to stick together. In the Bible said, Jesus, I am the vine, you are the branches. You have to abide with me. You will live. Jesus is the head, and we are the body of Jesus Christ. So you have to connect with Him. We have together, centered by Jesus Christ. And God will fill us. Amen. He's our head. So we are looks like incomplete and looks like imperfect. But God wants to fill us with His Holy Spirit, and we will be filled. In Jesus Christ, we have no lack, because God wants to fill everything to the church. Now, we are not perfect, but we will be perfect before the Lord. We are not satisfied right now, but we will be satisfied. In Jesus Christ, now we can feel something's not enough, but God will fill us. After that, we will say to each other, we are enough for that. Amen. The Bible said, the grace is enough. Grace is enough. In Jesus Christ. The Lord is my shepherd. Psalm 23, that is a very important word. The very famous word. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. I shall not want. The grace is enough for us. Amen. In Jesus Christ. Because some people, their eyes is darkened. They couldn't say anything. Even already, the grace is fully came to them. That grace is enough for them. That grace is upon us. Still, we need something more, something. That kind of things can't make us in peace in our hearts. So Paul wants to pray for that. You have to know that. You have to know about this perfection. You have to know about in Jesus Christ, your fullness has to know about it. Spiritual eyes has to be open, and you can see invisible church. That church is visible church today. Our church, Lomawai Church. It can be broken in the hurricane, but spiritual eye open, and you can see something real church there. Spiritual church is invisible. It is in you and me. That church is perfect. Visible church is imperfect. It's not perfect. It's not fullness. Still something we need. But invisible church in me, in us, that is perfect church we have to follow. Amen. Christ is our head. You have to know that. Many people still complain about that things. Still have a grumble in a church because they have no idea. Their eyes was darkened, so they can't see. We have to sing like this. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. I want to see you. So my eyes open, so I can see something. Fullness of the church. We have to know about it. So Paul is praying that. I also pray like this for our church, in the Lomawai and Naceva church. I also pray for all the Christian people. You have to know about it. First, hope the call. Second, riches of His glorious inheritance. Third, today Bible said, the power, incomparable power, you already have it in Jesus Christ. Amen. The power is overcome the death. The power overcome the world. The power to fill the church, the fullness of the body of Jesus Christ, the church. The head is our Jesus. Amen. Think about these three things. Think about it. We will overcome the death. We have no worry. We have no fear of the death. We have overcome the world. They never against us, because our Jesus has already beat them. He already won the victory. And third, today, the church, His body of Jesus Christ, He's the head. He is fullness, perfect, and complete, our church. Lastly, I just want to tell this one story. I just want to make it and I want to finish. Long time ago in history, in Greece, that Greece and Spartacus, they are fighting each other. They have a war. In that time, if they fight each other and they lose, they have to be a slave. What is the meaning of the slave? They're like a dog. He's not a human anymore. They can possess everything. Your children, your wife, no possess. Nothing. They treat it like an animal, like a cattle. That is very big trouble for the people. So what? They send them to the big plain of the war field. That war field, that ground name, it was Marathon. They are all warriors together in that place. That place is really far away from Greece. They have to fight each other. Just one day, they fight with the sword and they kill each other. And that war field, they have a big war. So even at night time, they saw that Greece have a victory to Spartacus. They are so happy. But far away from the people in the city, their family, their wife and children, they has no idea what's the who is when. This time we have a phone. Yeah, so I can call you. Yeah, we have a victory. Yeah, they can say that. But that time, how can? So this same time, the Marathon, in that place, have victory. They happiness, they have it. But that town, that city, has full of sadness, full of worry, is over there. So what? One man, one warrior, they start to run to give them a good news. So he has that good news to the people in the city. They run, 42.195 kilometers. So many people worry and watching somebody comes, and that one soldier has arrived to the city. And he said, we won the victory. What happened in the city? Big joy. Everybody shouted, wow, we are won the victory. We don't need to be a slave for them. We won. We have free. Why they has no idea they have power in a fashion? Because their eyes, heart of eyes, darkened. Amen. The sin blocked our eyes that we can't see anything. Still, we are here. Many people live in same time, like Marathon and city. Some people has to know about it. They has to know. We won the victory already. We already won. Jesus Christ already overcome the death, overcome the world. He already make our church, body of Jesus Christ, perfect. Still, many people in dark, so they had no idea. We have to tell them about it with the gospel, like that small soldier to run 42 kilometers. Something like that. Someone in a church still have a darkness in their eyes, so they couldn't see that. That's why they have a worry about their future, their lives. God saying to them, I won the victory for the death, so you have salvation. Even you die, don't worry. You can go into my place. The kingdom of God is yours. Amen. And say to them, the power of overcome the world. You don't need to afraid of the world. Amen. You don't need to worry about your future. God is look after everything for you and me, because you are the church of Jesus Christ. Amen. And he said, I will fill the church with everything in every way. In the Bible said, you will be perfect before the Lord. Amen. You will be. That prayer is ours. So we have to pray like this. Lord, your spirit of wisdom and revelation, we want to know about you more and more. I want to pray like this. Enlighten my sight, my eyes open, my heart is open, so I can know something better. The hope which you called us, and riches of his glorious inheritance. And today, Bible, you have a power already in Jesus Christ. He won the victory for the world already. He will fill the church with the fullness of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, thank you so much today. You want to give us today the Word of God. Lord, in the Bible said, Paul is asking you, not giving something. Please, let them know about you more and more with your Holy Spirit of wisdom and revelation. And enlighten my eyes, open my heart, open my eyes. So I want to see more and more. I want to know more and more about the hope which you called us. And also, we want to know about the riches of his glorious inheritance, the kingdom of God, and the power won the victory of the death for our salvation. The power which he has overcome the world. The power of the fill the church, to make that fullness and perfection. Thank you. Same thing to us. So we want to understand what you do. We want to live for you, Lord. We want to live for your glory and honor, Lord. Thank you so much. Please give our old church members to power and strength, so we can gather in our church in a long period. But please hold all the church members' hand, and they can get over every trouble in their life. Thank you so much. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide each and every one of us forever and ever. Amen.